this particular trip, we had talked about after our Italy trip with Jasmina Verziel, who graduated in 2011, and she's from Belgium. So we had talked about the idea of heading to Belgium to see her, knowing she was still living there and playing, with the hopes of playing her team. And then knowing France isn't too far from her hometown, we thought connecting France into the mix, and Dr. Zilmer brought up the idea of Amsterdam and Normandy, so worked out beautifully.
I'm ready.
I was excited personally because I've only been to Jamaica prior to that, and that was to help work a basketball camp. So I've never really been over to Europe or really experienced any other culture besides America. So I was really excited just to like see a lot of things. And then I was excited that we were gonna be able to play basketball, like get some games in before the season, see how the freshmen fit into the system. So that's always really exciting.
Well, when we packed originally, my bag was 47 pounds the first day. And I thought I was in good shape, and then I added my basketball stuff to it, and I went to 51. So there's a little bit of a problem there, but a lot of, or some teammates had bags that were a little lighter, so it worked out. We got everything over there and back under 50, which was nice.
We have arrived. Oh yeah. Sam, we wanna say something to the camera? Wanna say something to the camera?
Welcome to Holland.
Amsterdam is probably one of my favorite places. Me and Kelsey and Megan and Rachel actually took tandem bikes. We rented them for 14 euros. So we're like, oh, that's so cheap. We're doing it. It was for an hour. So we got on tandem bikes because over in Amsterdam, you just bike everywhere and the bikes basically get the right of way. So we did that for an hour. We got really lost. We had no idea where we were going. A man told us that we were pirates. I don't know if that was a compliment because we were really good at bike riding, or if he actually just like thought we were gonna steal something because we looked like we were out of place. But it was fun. I thought that was my favorite thing that happened in Amsterdam. It was definitely the bike riding.
And I was heading up north to a place that I know.
Well, it was beautiful. I love the idea that you can walk everywhere. It's one of my favorite things, to just get out and wander around and explore. And Amsterdam allows you to do exactly that. But just enjoyed the culture, the food, and we did a lot of touring, which was great.
Belgium, Amsterdam to Belgium was like night and day. So Amsterdam is this like wild city. People are everywhere. And then we pull into Belgium and we actually had to reverse down the street, and our bus driver Guy did a great job. He reversed a double-decker bus all the way down a street and he dropped us off in front of our hotel, and we got out in the street and there was probably three people who passed us in 15 minutes. So we went from like the most crowded place to a place that was not so crowded, but at the same time, it was still like really beautiful. There was canals and the architecture was really nice. So I think both places were really fun, but just a different type of fun and just the different type of culture.
We did a walking tour through Belgium and it was pouring rain. So our coaches got us ponchos and I ripped a hole in mine, of course. So it didn't really help. I continued to get soaking wet, but we were all really excited to try a waffle for the Belgium waffle. So we got waffles.
It was great. Yeah, it was just so nice to see her, and we were communicating back and forth. Obviously, this day and age, you can FaceTime players and text them no matter where they are in the world, which is great, but to see Jazzy in person was extra special. France, again, not even being concerned that first day with the weather. We had a rainy day, but we were ready to tour, and we had a great tour guide on that trip, and she had us singing on the bus. We stopped at the Eiffel Tower, and the girls, their favorite shot is everyone jumping in the air, so they certainly took advantage of the opportunity in front of the Eiffel Tower to capture that moment.
And we also went to Normandy, which I thought was really cool because we got a tour of that, and like we got to see like the like all the history behind it, which I thought was awesome. And our tour guide I thought was amazing for that.
I thought the best thing overall that we as coaches witnessed was the lack of drop-off, I guess is the best term. You know, we were subbing players in and out like throughout each contest. There are 10-minute quarters over there, which we had to get used to, you know, that's what we're gonna have here. And we were just rotating players in and out of the game, 12 of them, and there wasn't a drop-off. There wasn't confusion of what we're doing, what defense are we in, who am I guarding. You know, they really worked well together, and I think that's what we were most pleased with and wanting the girls to carry forward into the season.
I think everyone overall did great. I mean, we won 4 games out of 4, and it was a really good team basketball experience. After every game, I mean, we had a lot of like donors with us and stuff, and everyone said like, wow, you guys really share the ball or this or that, and it was nice to hear that. So I think overall it was good.
I'm looking forward to sleeping next to Sam again after 4 years. This is the first time that we're gonna be sleeping in the same room again since we first met.
It was incredible. I loved every second of it. 10 days was enough. I was ready to come back home now. You know, it's a lot of no sleeping and walking around and seeing everything. But to be able to like do that with my team, like people that like I like love and I really care about, to be able to go experience something that like is a once in a lifetime thing is incredible. And you get to connect with them on, it's not just basketball, you know, it's not just like hanging out, like you're doing both together. And then the fact that not only my team was there, but like supporters, like the administration, and they were incredible. I loved having them along because you can just, you always know they support you, but to actually like physically see it, like every game they came to, like they were cheering.
It's amazing, and it's something we talk about with recruits and their parents. It's one of the first things we mention. Just to have the support of our president and vice president and trickling down, and Dr. Zillmer has always been an advocate of our teams doing international travel, doing the foreign tours. It means a great deal. You know, we know it means a lot to the current players, but those that we are recruiting are aware of the opportunity presented that other schools aren't able to offer. So I've enjoyed each and every one, and this one, as I said, was special in the sense of heading to Belgium and seeing Jazzy, but I thought it was special to have Stan Silverman and Jackie on board, and have parents with us, and to have those from the university join us, because often you are just with your team, you know, traveling in and out, but to make it a big family and for them to get to know our players a little bit better in our program means a lot.